question. As far as some challenges are concerned, apparently we seem to be all synced up with the previous team. So,
you need a copy, right?
that's thinking, you can say that. Okay, so we'll start off with our first point, which is compromise testing to finish within the sprint. So, now these are some things which we are all seeing in our projects. This is, I'm sure all of us will be able to relate to a following scrum. That deliveries are happening towards the end of the sprint. QAs are taking that up. Sprint is about to end. They have their own set of pressures and they have to give that deliverable and move on to the next sprint, and testing is affected. So that's what we are seeing, and that's the first point, compromise testing to finish within the sprint. And that there we are seeing the quality also being affected. Okay. Next is sprint planning may not be sufficient. So we have backlog roaming and sprint planning sessions, but we are seeing that sprint planning sessions are not enough to probably look at all the user stories, come up with questions, resolve them, and eventually when we progress in the sprint, we realize that this is something which we did not consider, because those 4 hours or 6 hours or whatever 2 hours which were kept for a planning were not sufficient. And then when we are in the second week or a couple of days later into the sprint, we realize, this is not something we thought about. So sprint planning may just not be sufficient is what we are trying to say.
Okay, and implicitly here the point is also that like your sprint planning will not be good because your product backend grooming in the previous sprint was also not happening. So that's also matters. Like many teams don't do the product backlog grooming in the previous team, and that's why they come up like sprint planning is not good and they face a challenge. Like, okay, we didn't know about this and then
right. So day one you start with the sprint planning and that's when you're seeing the user story. So you haven't seen it before, you haven't stretched on backlog grooming, you see it for the first time, you have your own set of questions, you go out and next day you have to start development. So you're not on track.
It will affect the next sprint also.
Moving forward, offshore on-site model affects availability of stakeholders for various scrum summaries. I think this point was already spoken about, but although this has been addressed somehow by distributed scrum, but still, this appears to be a challenge where people are spread across geographical locations, product owners in somewhere, your team is somewhere else, you're trying to sync up, but your time zones are a challenge, they are always not available. So all these things are there. So And when Scrum says that people have to be together, etc., it becomes a challenge because that's not always possible. So we see it as a challenge here. Next is fixed bid projects are a challenge to deliver using Scrum. I think again somebody spoke, and maybe you would like to elaborate a bit.
Yeah, so it happens in our project. So it was fixed bid project, and after one sprint, customer came back and said, okay, we don't want this complete feature. But now imagine it's a fixed bid project, so you have completely all the three parameters are fixed. So it is a challenge. So we have a lot of challenges there, a lot of problems.
Right. So as we spoke earlier that, it gives the customer the luxury to change, and then when the change comes in somewhere in between and it's a fixed price, so outfalls are a lot larger.
Can I add something here?
Yeah, sure.
I have faced some challenge here in my one of the project, but in fixed price, what we could do efficiently, if we put these things, whatever customer required in a proper manner, in user stories, we will never face this challenge. I have overcome this challenge.
So in that scenario, this way, like say, like if you know fixed big project, your requirement, then go for the waterfall model, and that's why this is highlighted as a challenge for Scrum.
Sometimes we have forcefully been asked to do a Scrum, that's why we need to do it. But to just keep us in separate side, if we put everything in the proper in user story and just confirmation from customer.
Okay, moving forward, next is self-managed teams is not always a reality. I think I see a nodding of heads, so that's theory, but when it comes to reality, it is not always a reality. And people are not, that's something which we've covered in the next point. Project teams are not trained on Scrum. So what has happened eventually is that the organizations who were following Waterfall, they have now taken up Scrum and they've tried to map the roles, right? And there you see that there is a conflict. So project managers are, you know, as working as Scrum Masters, and all sort of confusion is there. You know, who's going to write user story? There is a solutions architect. He says, that's not my job. That's DA's job. DA says, no, it's not my job. It's the team's job. So it's all confusion. And that's where, you know, you have to point them to some, okay, this is what the organization is saying, and you need to agree to it. So project teams are not trained on Scrum. That's what you're saying. And this is very much required so that everybody understands who is supposed to do what.
And that will include even the product owner, because the product owner is such a role, like in the waterfall model, it was like when the company has a BA, but offline will be used to be only one requirement. But with the Scrum, now it has to introduce the product owner role. And most of the time we're hearing it from the client side, because the vendor company haven't got that much knowledge about the business domain in all. So that involves the role of the product owner, identifying the product role.
And the last points are estimations. I think for estimations, we see that, you know, always, I'm not sure how many of us are following story points, although that's what we follow back.
This is a huge challenge.
Yeah, so, you know, ours, you know, say these are contracted hours, how do we convert, and all that story gimmick plays around, and then we are stuck up with ours, and then you say, no, this is not proper Scrum. So estimations have always been a challenge. I don't know how XP and the other are going to address this, but that's something which I will be also interested to understand how they are able to, you know, manage estimations in there.
Good job.
One more point.
One more point.